heading right down, all of you. Stereoisomerism. We have two types, configurational and conformational. We are talking about configurational first, and in that also we are discussing geometrical isomerism. Okay, so stereoisomerism is what? Stereoisomerism is, you know, it is due to the different position of atoms or groups in the space. Okay. So stereoisomerism is defined as, or write down this way, isomers which has the same structural formula but different relative arrangements of atoms or group in space. Or we can also say the 3D arrangement is different, okay? Called stereoisomers. And this phenomenon is stereoisomerism. One second. To copy this, I'll just connect the charger. Give me just 1 minute.
Yeah. Automats we'll discuss, Pradyun. Not now, but we'll discuss later. Let it be. Okay. For now, you let it be. Okay. So, stereoisomerism is because of different arrangement in space of atoms or groups, right? It is basically because of different relative arrangements, the repulsion between the atoms or groups, you know, it either decreases or increases, which affects the overall stability and property of the molecule. And hence they are isomers. Correct. So in this, if you see, if you talk about geometrical isomerism, okay. So geometrical isomerism is because of restricted rotation. Write down. Geometrical isomerism GI is because of restricted rotation across the double bond ring or double bond inside the ring. Double bond, ring, double bond inside the ring. So what do you mean by this? Because it means that we can have three different conditions for geometrical isomerism to possible. Geometrical isomerism is possible because of double bond, because of a ring, and because of double bond inside the ring. These three different conditions we have. Okay. So look at this example. Suppose if I write down this molecule, CH3H and CHCH CH3H another one C double bond C CH3H CH3H and C double bond C HCS3. Do we have any difference in this two compound and in this two compound? Do we have any difference in the first one? Okay. The first one you see, the molecule is identical. It's the same molecule. We don't have any difference. because we can always rotate this sigma bond and we'll get this molecule. Okay, but here the rotation is hindered, because if you want to, if you fix this carbon and want to rotate this carbon, so you have to break this bond. And for isomers, we cannot break any bond. We can change the position, right? But the number of bond must be same, right? So if you want to rotate the second carbon, you have to break the pi bond which forms over there, okay? And hence we say we have restricted rotation across a double bond, which results into the different properties of these two molecules. So these two are isomers actually. What kind of isomers? Geometrical isomers. Because the relative distance here and here is different. Correct? Understood? What is the name of this compound? IUPAC name? The second one. Second pair that we have. Tell me, is it butadiene? How? What is the position of double bond there? Right, it is butadiene, correct? Both molecule is butadiene, yes? Correct. So now here what happens when the isomers or the concept of isomerism came into the picture, then the whole objective of IUPAC nomenclatures has got defeated. Why? Because the purpose of IUPAC nomenclature is that each and every molecule should have unique name. Correct? Should have unique name. But these two compounds are different compounds, different in their properties, melting point, etc. But they have the same name, that is butadiene. Okay. Now to overcome this drawback, we have given different terms to this kind of compound that we use only in case of isomers, right? Those terms are what? Those terms are, if you talk about geometrical isomers, it can be defined as cis trans. I'll write on the next page, wait. Write down the name of this type of compound. We have cis and trans nomenclature system. We have E and Z nomenclature system. We have syn and anti nomenclature system. Cis, trans, easy, syn, anti. Okay. Cis, trans, we use, you see here, we have carbon carbon double bond. One attached here, second group here, third group here, and fourth group here. So out of this four group, right, if only two are different, right, we must have two different group attached to this position, right? 1, 2, 3, 4. Only two should be different over here, not all four. So in that case, we use cis and trans isomers. Cis and trans we use when two atoms or groups are different out of four. With example, you'll understand. ENZ, write down, when more than two atoms or groups are different. Synonymity we use when we have carbon-nitrogen double bond or nitrogen-nitrogen double bond. In these two cases, we use this. Synonymity. Basically for nitrogen-containing compound. Okay, so for cis and trans, what we can write, if identical group are on the same side, on the same side, so cis, if identical group on the opposite side, then trans. Copy this. Okay. We'll do some example here. Like the first one, if you take CH3, C double bond C, CH3, H, H. So since anyone, if you see identical group, same side, so it is cis. This one also same side, cis only. If you talk about this one, C double bond C, H, Cl, Cl, H. Identical group, you can take either chlorine or hydrogen. On the opposite side, it is trans. Okay. If you have this, C double bond C, H, Cl, Br, and H. Now, this one is, again, it is highly substituted only, but since we have three different groups attached over here, so we can preferably write down E or Z isomers for this, right? Preferably we'll write E and Z isomers. How do we write E and Z? We'll see that later. But if you want to write down cis and trans, then we can write down cis with respect to the identical group, which is hydrogen here, it is cis. Got it? Write down ENG system of nomenclature. Write down ENZ system of nomenclature. Nomenclature we use when the alkene is highly substituted. Okay, when the alkene is highly substituted. Highly substituted means when the double bonded carbon atom has different group attached. If three groups are different, then also we can consider this as substituted alkene, highly substituted alkene. But if all the four groups are different, it is obviously highly substituted alkene. And in this case, cis and trans, obviously we cannot define because all the four groups are different. There's no identical group present. So in this case, what we do, we can write down the name of the compound using ENZ system, right? So to define ENZ, what we need to do, we need to assign priority on this group, which is attached to the double bonded carbon atom. So A and B will compare its priority. Suppose it is one, and this is two. Its priority is one, and this is two. Suppose I am getting this priority. Then what we'll write? If higher priority group are on the same side, then it is Z isomer. If higher priority are on the opposite side, it is E isomer. Okay, and write down, this has nothing to do with the cis and trans system of nomenclature. Done. This has nothing to do with the cis and trans system of nomenclature. This means what? E can be cis, E can be trans also. Similarly, Z, it can be cis and trans both. So it's not like Z is cis and E is trans. Don't confuse with that. Okay, Z can be cis or trans, E can be cis or trans. Anything is possible. Done. Now the whole question is, how do we assign the priority? Because if you are not able to assign the priority, you won't be able to find out the ENZ system of nomenclature. So first thing is to assign priority here. Okay. Any doubt here? Tell me. No. Okay. To assign priority, what we'll do, we'll have a rule given. We have CIP rule. The rule is CIP rule. So it is called, it is based on scientist name, three scientists named Kahn. We have Ingold and Prelog rule we have. CIP, Kahn, Ingold, Prelog. Four or five rules we have that you have to keep in mind. First one is higher atomic number has higher priority. The second one is, in case of isotopes, we compare mass number. So based on these two rules, you see, suppose you need to assign priority on fluorine, chlorine, bromine, and iodine. So iodine has highest atomic number. The priority order is this. Isotope, if you take tritium, deuterium, and protium. Tritium has highest mass number. The order of priority is this. If you talk about O18 and O16, O18 has more priority. Cl37 and Cl35. 37 has more priority. Done. Copy it, guys. Okay, next one is, if a group is attached, I'll write down like this. In case of a group, we compare the atomic number of first atom. For example, chlorine, SO3H, OH, NHCH2, NHCH3, and COH. So if you want to compare all these atoms or groups, we'll compare the atomic number of the first atom. Like for example, chlorine is atom only. Atomic number is 17. It is sulfur, 16. It is oxygen here, 8. Nitrogen, 7. Carbon, 6. So order of priority is this. Done. Sometimes what happens, the first atom is same, like you see this one. We have CH2, CH3. Other one is suppose we have suppose CH3. Other one is CH2, CH3. And other one is COOH. If these three groups you need to compare, first atom is carbon only. So obviously with first atom, we cannot compare that which one is higher priority, all are carbon. If we cannot decide on the basis of first atom, then we'll go for the second atom, which is hydrogen here. We don't have any choice. Here the second atom is carbon. Chain will follow. Here it is oxygen. So obviously the priority of oxygen is maximum, then carbon, and then hydrogen. Done. Okay. Write down next rule. The lone pair is considered as the least priority. Lone pair is considered as the least priority. Okay. Now you see this example, and how do we name this compound? ENC. Okay. We have carbon-carbon double bond. OH. Just tell me ENZ nomenclature. Try this 4 question. Done. Okay. So first one will assign priority. O and C. O is higher priority. 1, 2. Cl has 1. This is 2. Higher priority, same side. It is Z isomer. Carbon, 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 chlorine. Chlorine is the more. This is 2. This carbon, carbon, we cannot define. So hydrogen and carbon, it is 1, it is 2, again Z isomer. It is deuterium 1, hydrogen 2, chlorine 1. So it is also Z. This two, if you want to compare, the smaller ring will have the higher priority. This one and then this. That is Z. Check your answer. Yes, the smaller one has more priority. I'll show you how, but you can also keep that in mind. Okay. See, how do we do this? The ring wala, the last example that we have. You can go either clockwise or anti-clockwise here. Suppose I'm going clockwise. First, second, third, fourth, fifth, six atom we have like this. Here also we'll go clockwise. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So first atom, if you compare, it is only carbon and carbon. We cannot do. Second atom, oxygen, oxygen, cannot do. Third atom, carbon, carbon, cannot do. Fourth atom, carbon, carbon, cannot do. What is the fifth atom in both group? What is the fifth atom in both group? Ring one. The first one on the top, we have carbon, but the bottom we have oxygen, right? So oxygen has more priority. Hence, the below one, a smaller group, has higher priority than the upper one. Clear? Understood? Just a few more examples you see. Tell me this too. Z and E. Okay. See, nitrogen here, the fourth group we have, which is this lone pair. Here also we have one lone pair this side, and one is this side. So obviously, lone pair has the least priority. Higher priority opposite side, E. One, one, it is Z. Clear? Okay. We can write E and Z. But since nitrogen is present here, so preferably we can write this as anti and syn. This is also right. Correct? Understood? Okay. So now, this is the nomenclature system we have discussed for geometrical isomerism. What nomenclature? How do we do the name of the naming of the compounds? Now, what is the condition and under what condition a compound can show geometrical isomerism? So write down the heading condition for GI. Geometrical isomerism. Geometrical isomerism is possible under three different conditions. Okay. First one, geometrical isomerism because of double bond, because of ring, and the last one we have because of double bond inside the ring. In this, the first one you write down GI because of double bond. Due to double bond. Condition for a molecule having double bond to show geometrical isomerism is, like suppose we have this molecule C double bond C, we have A, B, and PQ. So atoms or group which is attached to the double bonded carbon atom must not be same. That is the condition for a double bond to show geometrical isomerism. Write down, for a double bond to show geometrical isomerism, for a double bond to show geometrical isomerism, the atoms or groups, attached to the double bonded carbon atom must be different. Right? So this means what? For this double bond to show GI, A must not be equal to B or identical to B, and P must not be identical to Q. This is the condition we have for GI due to this double bond. A can be equal to P or Q, B can also be equal to P or Q. Okay. So you must take care of this thing that here this two group must be different. AB will compare and PQ will compare. Any one of these two are same, P equals to Q or A equals to B, the double bond won't show GI. I'm giving you some example Just tell me that which compound can show GI. First one. Second one. Third one. This one. Okay. How many compound can show GI here? Only two. Others can also answer. First one, GI possible, because we have both hydrogen atom here, no GI possible for the first one. Second one, here it is fine, but here we have two hydrogen. So no GI possible for the two hydrogen. Across this, GI possible, yes. Across this also GI possible. So two GI possible here in the third one. Okay, the double bond across which geometrical isomerism possible, we call it as stereo center. So we have two stereo center in this SC, in this molecule. This double bond here, it is fine, but if you compare this side, okay, if you have a ring structure given like this, then what you do, you just go like this, anti-clockwise and clockwise you move. If you move anti-clockwise, you are getting CH2, CH2 and C. This is, we have CH2, CH2 and C. We can assume this side we have CH2, CH2, C present. These are the method to, you know, find out GI possible or not. If you go clockwise, then again, we are getting the same thing, CH2, CH2, C. And hence we say both path are same here, identical. Right? Both path are identical, same. And hence we can conclude that the identical group is attached both side on the top and on the bottom and on the top. Hence, GI is not possible here. No GI. If you compare this one, then this path is different because we have chlorine at first carbon. This side, we do not have chlorine at first carbon. So we have two GI possible here. Number of GI, how to find out, we'll see that. Concern here is the molecule will show GI. So this GI is because of double bond. So number of stereocenter here, if I write down, SC equals to 1. Tell me, how many of you understood this? Is it clear, guys? No, not 4. Only 2, na, for one molecule. Number of GI, you just let it be. We'll discuss that later. No, see. If the ring is attached to a double bond, no. You don't have to do anything. You try to move anticlockwise, see what all groups are present, and clockwise, see what all groups are present. If both groups are same like we have here, then it means both sides we have same group attached, and hence GI is not possible. So basically you need to just check the path is different or not, clockwise or anticlockwise, that is it. Okay, so condition for double bond is this. Similarly, we have condition for a ring to show geometrical isomerism. Second, write down, second point. Geometrical isomerism due to ring. Condition is at least two sp3 hybridized atom, at least two, we have two sp3 hybridized atom must be disubstituted with two different group. Okay, for example, you see, we have this molecule, CH3 attached here, H we have here, CH3 we have here, and H we have here, okay? So this carbon, you see, this carbon is sp3 hybridized. This carbon is sp3 hybridized, and two different groups attached to this carbon atom. Hence, this will show GI. Yes, GI possible. Number of stereocenter is 1, and we say this geometrical isomerism is possible because of ring. Ring is the stereocenter we have here. Any doubt? SC is the stereocenter. Okay, SC is the stereocenter, yeah. Second one, you see, tell me, in this one, GI possible or not? Tell me, is it possible? Yes, obviously hydrogen atom is present over there. We do not represent that. Yes, guys, answer. Okay, you see here, this molecule along with this carbon atom, we have, along with methyl, we have hydrogen present here. That is understood. And one hydrogen we have here. Similarly, here also we have hydrogen present. And here also we have hydrogen present. Correct? All these carbon atoms are sp3 hybridized. It is sp3. Two sp3 hybridized carbon atom is disubstituted. So in this case, yes, GI possible. Number of stereo center is one. In this case also, condition is at least two. So more than two also finds. Yes, GI possible. The number of stereo center is again the ring, that is one. In this also, yes, GI possible. The number of stereo center is still the ring, that is one. Done. Few more examples, you see. GI possible or not, and also find out the number of stereo center. Yes, tell me. The first one, it is possible, geometrical isomerism. No. If I write down this one, then yes or no? Then do double bond, right? Okay. So in that case, we have this double bond. Is it this double bond? Is it possible with this double bond? No. Why? Because this is equal. So double bond won't show. This molecule will not show GI, right? Further. If you add here CH3, then it shows. Number of stereo center? Number of stereo center is 1, that is this ring. Right? What if I place a double bond here? GI possible? How? Yes. Yes. So in this case also, GI is not possible because the carbon becomes sp2 now. We need sp3 hybridized carbon atom. So this we'll just remove. Answer for this molecule is yes, GI possible. Obviously, across this GI not possible because we have hydrogen here. Here we have one hydrogen present. So because of ring, GI possible. Because of double bond, GI possible. Overall, yes, geometrical isomerism possible. And number of stereo center is 2 over here. Number of stereo center is 2. Here also, because of this larger ring, GI possible. Right? So yes, GI possible. Number of stereo center is 1 here. That is a hexagon. Number of stereo center is 1, and that is the ring we have. Okay. Understood, all of you? Now, the third condition we have, that is geometrical isomerism due to double bond inside the ring. It's a factual, basically, you have to keep this in mind. GI due to double bond inside the ring. So for this one, the condition for this type of geometrical isomerism is that the ring must contains at least eight or more atom. Means the ring size must be at least 8 membered. Okay, that is the condition we have. Like you see this example, Okay. This molecule is cis cyclooctene. Because the hydrogen atom present like this, this way. Here, one hydrogen atom is this side, another one is this side. So this is trans cyclooctene. Trans cyclooctene. What happens if the ring size is less than 8 member ring? So in that case, what happens? The trans isomers are highly unstable. 2 points you write down in notes. First of all, you copy down this and then I dictate. Write down, for a smaller ring means smaller than 8 member. For a smaller ring, the trans isomers are highly unstable. The trans isomers are highly unstable due to strain, and hence does not exist. Right? That's why 7 and lesser carbon atom present in the ring, then double bond inside the ring does not show any kind of geometrical isomerism. You simply ignore that. Okay? Second point you write down. For 8, 9 and 10th and 10 member ring, for 8, 9 and 10 membered, cycloalkene you write down. For 8, 9 and 10 membered cycloalkene, cis isomer is more stable than trans. Cis isomer is more stable than trans. Cis isomer is more stable than trans. Next line. For 11 and larger member ring, trans is more stable. The last 2 points you must keep in mind, it's a factual, okay, experimental based fact we have, so you have to memorize it. Should I repeat again? Is more stable because in trans what happens, you see, this hydrogen and this hydrogen, we have repulsion here. Because of this dihedral repulsion, trans becomes less stable than cis. Cis, we do not have any repulsion, you see here. Okay. Tell me, GI possible or not, and number of stereo center. Larger member ring, 11 or more. See, trans is always more stable because we have the two groups present at more distance. The distance is more between the two identical group. But trans is generally more stable than cis, okay, because of less repulsion over there, because the identical groups are far away from each other, relatively. Right, so in 11 member ring, we don't have that repulsion that I have shown you just now. Larger ring, so more space. It can accommodate the hydrogen atom over there, and hence the repulsion is less. Tell me, which one shows GI? If GI possible, number of stereo center. Done. Tell me the answer. First one, GI possible. You can type Y or N. First one. Any one condition is there. Any one. We consider this yes. Right? So across this double bond, yes, GI possible. Because of ring, Y or N? Because of double bond inside the ring? N. So yes, GI possible, but the number of stereo center is 1 here. Because of this double bond? This double bond? Yes. Because of ring? Because of ring? Yes. Because of double bond inside the ring? Yes. Double bond inside the ring, we have yes. Right. Yes, DI possible. And SC equals to 3. This one? Because of ring, it is possible because this is also sp3 hybridized. Nitrogen is also sp3 hybridized with a lone pair on it. So yes, DI possible. That is because of ring. SC is 1. One very important example we have in JEE, they have asked this question. See, this kind of compound, when we have continuous double bond like this, you see, C double bond C, double bond C like this, and it goes on. Right, this kind of compound, the common name is cumulenes, or alenes also we call it as. C-U-M-U-L-L-E-N-E-S, cumulenes, common name, right? So when we have even number of double bond, like double C, double bond C, double bond C, double bond C, like this it goes, right? So if you have even number of double bond, even number of double bond, then the molecule is non-planar. Even number of double bond, we call it as even cumulenes. Right? And this kind of compound does not show geometrical isomerism. Okay. I'll write down here CH3, H, and in this one, it looks like trans. But GI is not possible in this one because it has been observed that in even cumulenes, since this is in different plane, this is in different plane, non-planar molecule, then the distance between this methyl group and this methyl group is same only. The distance difference is not there. And hence the relative repulsion is also same. If it is L, this is also L. Hence the relative repulsion is same. Relative repulsion is same. Correct. So it does not show GI. Property will be same in that case. Okay. Keep that in mind. Even cumulenes is non-planar and it does not show geometrical isomerism. If these groups are different, it can show optical isomerism, right? Non-planar does not show GI. But can show optical isomerism. Why? So in optical isomerism, we'll discuss this also. Must remember this, keep this in mind, it's very important. Once again, Aro. Correct. So here the condition of GI is done over. We are now left with properties. Anusha, we'll discuss this. I'll tell you this. After the break, you can copy this down. Okay, we'll continue this after the break. I just said one thing. I'll take one minute. When you have continuous double bond like this, this kind of compound, we call it as cumulenes, general name. Okay. When you have even number of double bond, like we have in this case, then this cumulene is non-planar. How and why, we'll discuss in optical isomerism. Okay. But don't get confused that this CH3 same side, so it is cis and this one is trans. No. Since it is non-planar, so distance between the methyl group here and here is same. So relative repulsion is also same. There's no difference in these two molecules. as far as the repulsion is concerned, correct? And hence there is no GI possible for this two molecule, correct? That is what it means. Keep this in mind. In optical isomerism also we'll see this. So this even number of cumulanes does not show GI, but it can show optical isomerism. Correct? Take a break. We'll resume at 6:38. Okay, take a break. Heading right down, properties. Okay. See, when you talk about boiling point, or suppose dipole moment, so dipole moment is directly proportional to the boiling point. Okay. It is also directly proportional to the solubility. Heat of combustion, heat of hydrogenation, density, refractive index, okay? So dipole moment is associated with all these properties of the molecule. Okay. Second one, if you talk about thermal stability, thermal stability and melting point. Melting point depends upon packing, okay? And melting point of trans isomer is more. Because in trans we have better packing, hence we have more melting point. Now only these two you need to memorize. Now, how do we compare the dipole moment, correct? Copy down this first. Okay. So we know dipole moment is a vector quantity. No, by mistake, I wrote 638. It was 633 actually. Anyway, just now we started. Did you copy? Okay, I'll go back. Copy this. Done. Okay. Yeah. Okay. So dipole moment, how do we compare? Dipole moment is represented by mu, and it is a vector quantity. Directed from positive to negative. Dipole moment, positive to negative. Look at this example. We have C double bond C, CH3H. Okay, so actually what happens when a bond is polar, like suppose hydrogen chlorine bond, it is more electronegative, so delta negative and delta positive. So because of this electronegativity difference, we'll have some charge develop over here, and because of this charge, we'll have a dipole moment from positive to negative direction. That is what the meaning we have. So whenever we have electronegativity difference, some charge develops that leads to polarity in the bond and then in the molecule. Okay. If you look at this carbon atom, which is attached here, this one is sp2. This one is also sp2. And this carbon here and here, these two are sp3 hybridized carbon. We know the electronegativity of sp2 is more than sp3. So what happens after some time, because of electronegativity difference, this would be delta negative, this would be delta positive, delta negative and delta positive, right? And hence we have, a net dipole moment in this direction because of this bond, positive to negative, right? It's a vector quantity, so it is there in this direction, it is there in this direction, and hence we have a net dipole moment in this direction, mu net, which is obviously not equal to zero, and we say the molecule is polar. We don't have to count or calculate the dipole moment exact value, we just need to check whether it is zero or not. This is cis, correct? This one was cis. If you talk about trans, then what happens, you see? CH3, C double bond C, CH3, H, H. So here we have dipole moment, positive to negative, this direction, right? And then we have positive to negative this direction, sorry. Equal dipole moment in opposite direction. These two will cancel out, okay? And the dipole moment here, mu2, here suppose it is mu1, right? Obviously it is getting canceled over here. Here it is not getting canceled. So we can say mu1 is greater than mu2. Cis has more dipole moment here than trans. When cis has more dipole moment, means the boiling point of cis is more, the solubility of cis is more, heat of hydrogenation more, heat of combustion more, okay, density more, reactivity index more, anything. Yes, did you understand? So here the cis has more dipole moment than trans, but we cannot generalize this. We cannot say the cis will always have more dipole moment. Okay, look at this example. Suppose we have CH3 C double bond C, Cl, H, and H. C double bond C, Cl, H, CH3, and H. Right? Positive, negative, this is the direction of dipole moment. Positive, negative, because chlorine is more electronegative. This is the direction of dipole moment. This one is obviously cis. Why cis? Because both hydrogen on the same side. Okay. This one is trans because hydrogen on the opposite side. Positive to negative and positive to negative. This two will add up. We'll get mu two here. We'll get mu one. Here the direction of dipole moment, net direction will be this, in this direction. But obviously this two is getting add up. So this one is obviously more than this. So in this case, dipole moment of cis is less than the dipole moment of trans. So we cannot generalize this, that the dipole moment of cis is always more than trans. It depends upon what is the bonding, what is the structure, what is the molecule we have. Acha, tell me which one is E and which one is Z, left and right. E or Z? Which one is Z? First one is Z and second one is E, right? Okay, so we can also say this is Z and this is E. Okay. What if I place here, instead of H, if I place here C, H3? Then what happens? E or Z? The second one, it's E. Okay. This one is E. If I ask you cis and trans, it is cis. Okay, cis. So always keep this in mind. Cis can be anything. You see, here cis is Z, here cis is E. So don't get confused that cis is always Z and trans is always E. This is not true. Okay. This can be cis, can be Z, cis can be E, and trans can be Z also, depending upon what is the molecule we have. Correct? Just I'll remove this. And this also. We had H over here. Correct? Okay. Now the last one in geometrical isomerism, that how to calculate the number of GIs. For this, we have formula that we need to follow, okay. Logically also you can draw the structure and find out, but that logic won't work. I should not say it won't work, but when you get some bigger molecule, then with logic, you'll get confused. It is difficult to, get answer from the logic. Okay. But because you need to draw the structure and it will be very complex if you are going to draw all the structure to count the number of GI. Okay. So best is to memorize the formula. What formula we have. So we'll count the number of stereo center basically, first of all. We'll count the number of stereo center. That is N. If N is equals to 1, then the number of GI, geometrical isomerism, is 2 to the power 1, that is 2. Cis, trans, syn, NT, easy, we can say. Okay? If N is greater than 1, then the number of GI would be 2 to the power N if the ends of the polyene are different. I'll tell you what does it mean. First of all, you copy down the formula. It is equals to 2 to the power n minus 1 plus 2 to the power p minus 1 if ends are same. Once again. This is the formula we have. Copy down this. Okay, done, copied. Now, how do we do this, use this formula, you see? Suppose we have a molecule, say CH3CH, double bond CH, CH3. GI possible, obviously the number of stereocenter is 1. So number of GI is equals to the formula is 2 to the power 1, that is 2. Which means we can, across this double bond, we can draw cis and we can draw trans. Hence two isomers possibly. Okay, look at this question. We have CH3, CH double bond, CH single bond, CH double bond, CH single bond Cl. Ends of this molecule is different. You see here Cl and Cl and CH3 we have, means ends are different over here. If it is CH3, then ends are same. Number of stereocenter is 1 and 2. So n value is 2. If ends are different, the number of GI would be, the formula we have, 2 to the power n, where n is greater than 1. That is 2 to the power 2, 4. Means the possibility is what? Across this double bond, cis, trans, cis, 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 trans, trans, cis, trans, trans. Hence, we are getting 4. So, 4 possible combination we have. One is cis, other one is trans. One is cis, other one is cis. One is cis, one is, wait. This one is trans, this one is cis, this one is trans, this one is trans. These are the 4 possible combinations we have. Hence, answer is 4. So like this also, you can analyze that for a given molecule, how many cis-trans structure you can draw. What happens if this is equal, CH3, CH3, here it is CH3, here it is CH3. Then one of this 4 possibility that we have, that you need to eliminate, because both will give the same thing, because ends are same there. Once you draw the structure, you will get it. Another example you see, we have C6H5 CH double bond CH single bond CH double bond CH single bond CH double bond CH single bond CH double bond CH Cl. Tell me the number of GI here. CH3CH double bond CH single bond CH double bond CH single bond CH double bond CH2. Number of GI here. CH3C double bond CH double bond CH single bond CH double bond CH, CH3. This one we have done, no? So try this 3. Done. Sixteen, 8, and 3. Okay. So number of stereocenter here, 1, 2, 3, and 4. Ends are different. Number of GI, equals to 2 to the power 4, that is 16. Number of stereo center, 1, 2. This is not the stereo center because we have CH2 here. So number of GI would be 2. Ends are different. So 2 to the power 2, that is 4. 1, 2, ends are same. N value is 2. P value is N by 2. That is 1. So number of GI would be 2 to the power N minus 1 plus 2 to the power P minus 1. That is 3. Formula you check, Oro. N is even, so P is equals to N by 2. Check the formula. Done? No, previous one that ends are not same. You see it ends is this. Okay. This one you check. Done. What is the answer? No, methyl ethyl is different. No, so they are different. It is the group attached to the double bonded carbon atom. This carbon you need to check which group is attached. Correct. Yeah. So how many stereo center here? 1, 2, and 3. Ends are same. N value is 3. So P value is what? N plus 1 by 2. That is 2. Number of GI would be 2 to the power N minus 1 plus 2 to the power P minus 1. 2 to the power 2 plus 2 to the power two minus one, right? Yeah. Four plus two, six we are getting here. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Did you write the formula, Oro? Check that once. n value is 4. No, 2 to the power n minus 1 plus 2 to the power p minus 1 it is. Yes. See this. Check the last one. I'll come back to the previous one. Ends are same. N value is 4. What is the number of GI when the ends are same? Or tell me. Number of GI is the same formula that you have written just now. 2 to the power n minus 1 plus 2 to the power p minus 1. Correct? Yeah. What is n value? 4. If n is 4, could you tell me what is the value of p? See the, check the formula over first and tell me. If n is 4, what is the value of p? I don't think you have written this. Wait. Did you copy this? That's what I said. Copy down first. Okay. So p value is 4 by 2. We'll substitute it here. 2 to the power 4 minus 1. Any doubt? Okay, so this is here, it is geometrical isomerism is done over here.